This is a charming home, love.
Good evening.
Good to see you.
Need something?
We heading out? I'll just be here then.
Food. I just can't stop thinking about food. Delicate sweet rolls, pies, pheasant roasts. Thank you. I can help with whatever needs carrying, you know. You don't look too comfortable. So, what's on your mind? Of course, love. I'll see you in bed. Morning. What now? Let's stories.
Ah.
So, what do you want to talk about? All right. I'm glad you're here.
Still here. I'll be sure to put it to good use. Let me know if you need anything. What can I do for you, friend? I suppose I can help. You lead. I'll follow.
So, where are we off to now?
Just you and me against the world now. Not that I'm complaining.
Yes? Take a look.
This house looks adorable. You're a great builder.
They used to call this city the City of Kings, in my books anyway. I wonder how Windhelm looked back in my time.
You're one of the same kind, you and I. I'm glad to have met you.
have anything exotic? Something no other woman would be wearing.
If you're looking for passage, talk to Captain Gyal.
If you're looking for passage to Solstheim, too bad. I'm not going back there anymore. Sure. Yeah, that's me. Why? Who sent you? Now, hold on. That wasn't my fault. I didn't know they were going to attack anybody. I don't even know how I got here.
It's hard to explain. I remember those people with the masks coming on board. Then, the next thing I remember, I was here, and they were gone. That's not right, losing whole days like that. There's been something strange going on there for a while. But after this, I'm done. I'm not going back to Solstheim. Have you been listening to me? I'm not going back there. All right. You have a point. Taking you back to find out who sent them is the least I can do. Besides, maybe you can put a stop to whatever's going on over there. I owe them a bit of payback myself. Well, here we are. This is Ravenrock. Can't say I'm all that glad to see it again. Good luck. Maybe you can figure out what's going on around here.
Didn't you know not to take me out on late-night escapades? I'm tired.
So, where are we off to now?
It's cold. And very, very dusty. I kind of expected this, but gods, this is just a bit too much. Even as a daughter of Cold Harbor, this is kind of hard for me. We should really get indoors, or even in a cave, somewhere.
I don't recognize you. So I'll assume this is your first visit to Ravenrock, Outlander. State your intentions. Mirak, I'm not sure that I do. Just remember, Ravenrock is sovereign territory of House Redoran. This is Morrowind, not Skyrim. While you're here, you will be expected to abide by our laws. Any questions? I'm unsure. I swear I know the name, but I cannot place it. I don't think so. I'm not... The name has something to do with the Earthstone, I think, but I'm not sure what. I have to be. As second counselor, the security of Raven Rock is my primary concern. This isn't exactly the city of Blacklight. We're on the frontier out here. We've had more than a fair share of troubles. After all we've been through together, I refuse to let Councillor Morvain down. Councillor Morvain is House Redoran's representative on Solstheim. As second counselor, it's my job to support him and make certain his rule is enforced. Ravenrock started out as an imperial settlement, but the Empire decided to abandon it, just as my people were first setting foot here. They left the town a shambles, and when House Redoran took over, we turned it around and it became ours. And even if it's been a struggle to make this island livable, we're proud to call it home. Your ignorance of our homeland doesn't surprise me. It's the capital of Morrowind. Been that way ever since Mournhold was sacked by the Argonians. I don't visit there often anymore, but we still get the occasional supply ship and visitors from there. Quite a while ago, yes. They cut a bloody swath across most of the southern region of Morrowind. Nobody seems certain why it happened. Attempted expansion? Revenge for the enslavement of their people, or perhaps both. Whatever the case may be, thousands of Dunmen needlessly lost their lives, and many more were exiled from their homeland. Giolan, I was starting to wonder what happened to you.
We were delayed by bad weather.
Stop thinking about food. Delicate sweet rolls, pies, pheasant roasts. I'm glad you're here.
Other than the smorgasbord of dust particles here, it seems unique in a lot of ways. Solstheim basically seems like an island version of Skyrim. But it's also different in many others. The flora, for one. You wouldn't see something like Trauma Root while walking the shores of Dawnstar, that's for sure. Sildstriders as well. That's definitely a Vardenfell thing. Turning giant bugs into organic carriages by manipulating their organs. Who would have figured? I'm glad you're here with me.
Nothing I can do about it.
After all these years, they're gouging us for every last drink we have.
Let me talk to Merrill. I'll see what. All right, don't worry about Russia. Just maybe when you can.
Take a seat and get the cold out.
Just you and me against the world now. Not that I'm complaining.
Welcome to the Retching Netch Corner Club, home of the finest Sue Jammer that will ever grace your lips. There's actually a funny story behind the name, friend. A few years ago, I was walking down by the docks, and I noticed a Dunmer staggering along with a bottle of Sue Jammer in hand. He was one of my patrons, and liked to drink heavily. So I wasn't exactly surprised. Ah, but you see, this particular Dunmer was as naked as the day he was born, and singing badly at the top of his lungs. As I'm watching this spectacle, a netch floats over the bulwark towards him. The man looks straight up at the netch, yells, "Have a drink!" and tosses the bottle. And it never hit the ground. Well, the bottle broke on the netch, and it must have swallowed its contents because it started floating sort of tilted. Finally, it stopped and began to quiver. A few moments later, the foulest liquid to ever assail your nostrils spewed from its maw. I've seen plenty of drunks in me day, and I'll tell you right now, that netch was sick. True story, friend. True story. The finest Sue Jammer across your lips, friend. My own personal formula that I call Sadri's Sue Jammer. In fact, I've just added some new ingredients to the mixture that I think makes it taste better than ever. All I need to do is get the word out when it's ready, and they'll flock here for it. I was kind of hoping you'd say that. Here. Take these samples of the Sue Jammer and spread the word. If you get rid of all of them, there's something extra in it for you. Welcome to the Retching Netch Corner Club, home of the finest Sue Jammer that will ever grace your lips. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room, right this way. Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Nice. A warm hearth and warm beds. Who could ask for more?
Still here? Certainly. Let me know if you need anything. Oh, that's so sweet of you. Thanks. I'm right behind you. I suppose I can help. Oh, that sounds lovely. Let me know if there's anything else you need. Still here. I understand.
Right behind you.
Ravenrock, was it? The East Empire Company sure knows how to pick interesting names. There's a bit of irony there, as this settlement really is now more Dunmer than anything. Just look at just about anything, really. The houses, the people, the general lay of the land. Looking at this place alone, I definitely feel this was someplace in Vardenfell. Tell you what, maybe. At least after all our adventuring in Skyrim is over. Would you like to visit Morrowind? I've always wanted to go there. I always found their culture peculiar, but interesting.
Can I help you? I understand.
I'm glad you're here with me.
Sure thing. Do you want to have it standing here, or do you want to find a seat first? All right, what do you need? I'm on it. Here should be fine. So, are we ready to start? All right. Now, on to the drinks. Do you want to have mead, wine, or just plain milk? Like a true Nord. Good pick. Likewise. How does it feel to be the mighty hero of Skyrim, distinguished for such tasks as being a courier, being a courier, being a courier, and lastly, being a courier? What? It's true. Almost everything you've done revolves around that. Go to this place, kill some things, pick something up, and deliver it to someone. Our adventuring has been getting more tiring lately. It's as if the world is responding to your growing power. As you get stronger, enemies get stronger. Which is why stress relief is all the more important. I know you want it. Just ask, and this girl is all yours. So, what do you say? Up for a little combat training later? I know. I was just remembering the castle courtyard, back before when things were better between us, between my mother and I. We'd tend to our garden back there. It was really nice, you know? It was cared for by an alchemical master and nurtured for hundreds of years, which makes it all the more sad that the garden will never look the same. So, what do you want to talk about now? I have, actually. And if I wasn't an adventurer now, I would probably be running a shop or two. Maybe even a conglomerate, if the divines would permit. Ever since I was a child back on the island, I'd particularly be interested in the merchants that would come to our castle every now and then. Of course, these were weird merchants, to say the least, with peculiar and eccentric collections. These vendors make even Bellathor look weird. My father was kind of into those things, though. I mean, it wasn't anything particularly weird for someone who fancied himself as vampire royalty, and who also was a staunch danger worshipper. Point is, there was just something in how these men sold and marketed their products. Kinda made me interested in the whole shopkeeping thing. Weird shopkeeping things, but still.
It's nice, spending time like this, just having drinks together.
Drayla, I have a message for you.
Tell my father if he wants to speak to me. He should do it in person.
It's not from your father. It's from Captain Velith.
Oh my goodness. I'm so sorry, Geldis. Please, tell me, what did he say?
He said he'll meet you where you met for the first time. He said you know what it means.
I do. Thank you.